brought to you by GTA, your island, your network.
Four procurement attempts and 4 years later, and students at Simon Sanchez High School continue to suffer after continual protests have prevented the school from receiving the renovations it desperately needs. Superintendent John Fernandez.
We're frustrated that it appears that the procurement is stalled, and we'd like to find whatever way we can to expedite the renovation that everyone's been waiting for.
The process to fix the dilapidated campus was halted again on Monday after prospective bidder Cortec International filed a protest with the Department of Public Works on September 7th. We should note CTI has filed at least three protests in previous procurements, all of which were denied by DPW and subsequently appealed to the OPA. The OPA's mixed decision on the appeals led the legislature to change the procurement process completely in June, with Senator Tom Atta arguing the new process would be less susceptible to protests. It's unclear what CTI's latest protest is based on, as Assistant Attorney General Tom Keeler confirmed the document cannot be released publicly at this time.
And I think the patience wearing thin, I know here at DOE, as well as with all the Simon Sanchez students and families and stakeholders who've been involved, we want to see this work get done and get done right.
Because of delays seen over the past several years, the department has had to address temporary fixes at the GEGO campus in order to avoid double session this year. Fernandez said the repairs have been completed, and while they should keep the school open, a full renovation is still needed. The school was shut down in 2013 and also received enough public health demerits to close in 2015. Phil Flores is the director of the Guam Educational Facilities Foundation, another company vying for the project.
They're not going to wait us out. We're going to compete. But the people who are suffering, the students and the faculty and the staff at Simon Sanchez. And you know what? I've said that about 50 times because they have filed so many protests and so many appeals. And they're obviously just trying to stop it.
Flores said the only potential issue he can see is the size of the requested campus, noting that while the home of the Sharks has fewer students than John F. Kennedy High School, the procurement requested a campus that was 25,000 square feet larger than JFK.
So it may be that they're trying to reconcile that mistake with the protest, but what Cortec is complaining about, I have no idea.
Meanwhile, the latest delay has Senator Joe Sinagustin questioning DPW's ability to lead the procurement process.
And that maybe we need to figure out a way how to, if need be, amend the law so that GEDA or DOE handles the bid itself and we get this going.
Meanwhile, Keeler said a decision on the protest is expected in the next week. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Issa Baza.
Brought to you by GTA, your island, your network.